out of the melee. Another little shopping trip. Rather howling and icy wind today. Right in my face, of course, just like it was on the way out here. It's one of those winds. Labouring up a hill. This bike still has its standard Dutch gearing as well, so it might not be the ideal bike for what I'm about to do with it next, which I'll show you. Very hub nut. Very hub nut. Against this wind all the way here. I used to have a Berlingo just like that. Absolutely loved it. Convinced myself that I needed something bigger for all the dogs. We're having a car-free week or two at the moment. Last Friday, which is 8 days now, the old Passat estate was written off while parked. So while we release some equity from a policy, instead of waiting around for a pittance from the insurance company, finding it a little difficult looking for cars during the lockdown. So I'm not in a hurry. We'll see what comes along. In the meantime, everything is being done by bike, and it is to that end that I'm bringing you along. Ooh, there. This trip is going to solve one of the problems. Another uphill again. Whoever said Blackpool is flat never came north and inland. This end of Blackpool is not. Now, if you've seen this bike on its various outings on the channel, you may have noticed that it's getting steadily more rusty with every outing. That is, apart from the stainless steel parts, that's another downside of living here, unfortunately. We have an almost constant westerly, which blows in from the sea, a mile that way. And so, not only does it rain an awful lot, but that rain is salt bearing. And even on non-rainy days, and there's salt on the wind, you can taste it sometimes. So it's just a nasty, nasty place for anything metal, anything ferrous anyway, to live outside. Which is why I have beta bikes like this, which after the winter is over will either be serviced and put away for next winter, or this will be stripped down and refurbished, and then something else will come out for next winter. But they also, excuse me a moment. I also took the Romain, my previous winter beater, off the road because the deterioration was more than I was prepared to put up with. Now, my task here always seems to be to get something from the back. Today is no different. And the thing that I want from the back is right at the back. See that blue carrier hanging down? That's a Pashley carrier bike. It's to the left of there and down in that area is where I need to get in and get it out. Looking at it now, I'm always wondering if it's worth it, but of course it is. It's bound to be worth it when I get it out. It's in two parts, and you'll see when I've got it out. Rally Sports 26x1. A couple of years ago I bought a stash of surplus Dutch chain cases and mudguards. Yeah, didn't quite realise how many there were. I've been thinking of refurbishing my BOB trailer, and I was concerned because I couldn't find my pair of nuts, which are used to hitch the trailer to the rear spindle of the bike. I've just found them. On my last sliver of battery, this is the item. Comes complete with this contraption, which I will show you later, which stays on the bike. It's quite old. I don't know what vintage it is. I might figure that out when I'm refurbishing it. But there it is, complete with upside down bicycle. And now I've got to get it home. So, meanwhile, it got dark. So we shall discuss the trailer in the morning. Its history and what's going to happen with it. Meanwhile, let's address the large green elephant that was sat in the trailer. It is a bit of an elephant in my room, is this motor bican. You've seen it before, being hauled in and out of this shed at various points. And I made a little video. I called it a motorbike can that deserves better. deserves better because it's a cute frame with beautiful colours and graphics on it. And and horrible components, just cheap steel all over it, cottage chain set look, steel seat posts, steel wheels, steel handlebars, in a nice alloy stem, it has to be said. So it deserves better, and it's always been my intention with this bike to I've knocked my lamp over, that's better. It's always been my intention with this bike to take it right down to the frame and replace everything, just upgrade everything on the bike that needs upgrading. The brakes are nice. Rebranded Wainmans, I think. But I mean, you know, steel handlebars, dear. So back on topic. I was going to strip it right down, replace everything with nice alloy. And it's sat there, and it's sat there for 3 years now, waiting for that to be done, which is patently not going to be done at this rate. So I thought, why not just enjoy it? I can't be coping with drop bars these days. I'm going to put drop bars into the Crown Star here, which I have not finished. In order to just press this into use with the components it's got, I'm just going to pop some nice flat mustache style handlebars on with some white grips on. When I do the eventual upgrade, it'll get nice handlebars with the white bar tape that I have set aside for it. I'm just going to quickly go through it, change what needs to be changed, and I'll pop a saddle on it, pop some nice flattish moustache type handlebars on, and some shifters, because obviously it's got down tube shifters, so that's no good with flat bars, it's too much of a reach. And get it out on the road and just have some fun with it while I wait to give it a proper upgrade all round. But rather than it sit in that lockup for another year before I even get around to looking at it, I'm sick of looking at it and feeling sad, feeling guilty. So let's get it out and have some fun. Meanwhile, the Rally Superb that's popped the rear tyre off, that's now got a Michelin World Tour back on it, and its original tyre, the troublesome 12, is here. This is what I found on it. Pieces of the beading have come out there. So this section here basically has no structural integrity to it, and that's the part that was popping off. So pieces of beading wire have just snapped and come out, and that's why that Schwalbe Delta Cruiser failed. Incidentally, somebody asked me about what a strange name Delta Cruiser is. It's referring to the Rhine Delta, which forms much of the Netherlands, and they were made as a tyre for Dutch bikes for the Dutch market by Schwalbe. Another Schwalbe tyre with an interesting name is that one there, the two brown ones on the top there, the Fat Franks. They were designed for a German company called Retrovelo for their retro style bikes, particularly one called the Paul. And the owner of the company was this chap called Frank, who was a friend of the one of the product development people in Schwalbe, I don't know who. And so the tyre was named after him because it was made for him. But unkindly named the Fat Frank. So that's why they're called that. The Big Apple, because it was for the American market, the New York cargo bike couriers. So the Crown Star has had almost nothing done to it since you saw it on its last video. It just needs finishing off, really. I've found a nice little single shifter for it, a nice old simplex, so that's on there. The mud guards have been refurbished, looking beautiful now. I just need to paint those brackets. Nice new reflector on them. There we are. Nice new reflector. They were done with T-cut, good old T-cut. Nice buffing. Various other components have been on the buffing wheels and being cleaned up. The next to be done are the wheels. That's why they're there. I've just started doing them. You see one of the rims is shinier than the other. I'll show you a little bit of the cleaning up of the wheels, particularly the hubs. Got some tyres out, ready to go on it. Got some Conti Top Touring. These were a 1980s tyre, well, 90s. And they were a bit of a legend among the cycle touring fraternity. I'm looking for a name, there we are. A distinctive tread, bomb-proof tyre that never seemed to wear out. Reasonably supple. Not so bad, for its day it was supple anyway. So I might stick those on. They're the right size, 27 inch. I'm limited in what I have, 27 inch. There are these, which are more of a city bike tyre, the Rally Record pattern. Not appropriate for this bike, I think. Or of course Michelin World Tour there behind. So I'll decide what to put on the Crown Star. Those city bike ones might even go on the Mother Buchan. This is the type of 27 that you can commonly get these days, sort of a semi-touring type. They might be all right on the Crown Star as well. And maybe put the city bike tyres on here while it's in this configuration. Then when I upgrade everything, it'll go to 700C wheels, which are 8mm smaller, so 4mm in radius smaller. So a perfectly easy swap. And giving you slightly more tyre clearance as well. And the Gazelle that I showed you last week did get the Michelin World Tour put on the front, and of course the tube repaired as well. I haven't done that paintwork yet that we discussed. And that is the state of things as they are now. You see the big green Gazelle, which is sold, is still here, mostly due to general awkwardness over the coronavirus and lockdown and such like. The biggest hurdle with this, actually, fortunately the buyer is in no hurry, and I'm keeping them appraised with what's happening. The biggest headache has been getting a box for it. The bike shops, yeah, they're open, they've been selling bikes, but not many, cause this time of year. So bike boxes are not thick on the ground, and then it's a matter of going into the shop more or less unnecessarily. Then they've got to get the box out. There's all the proximity risks and social distancing problems to do with them getting a box out and giving me a box, and it's just not been easy getting hold of a box to send this in. Otherwise it'll be off to Doncaster area very shortly. I haven't ridden it again. I will give it a test ride before I dismantle it. The gear cover is off because the cable bedded in a little bit and the gears went out when I did ride it. I had to put an original Gazelle kickstand on rather than the huge thing that I'd put on before, which fouled the rear brake rod mechanism, so it's back onto a normal type of Gazelle stand. And I think that's all the updates. When I've quickly done this Motorbikan and finished the Crown Star, which will probably be tomorrow, the next two jobs are my big Gazelle Populaire to get its 8-speed rear wheel put in and set up, and this pair of Rally 20s, one of which belongs to my friend Jeff, the green stowaway there, and the gold and bronze one belongs to me, and they're both getting a light refurb. And I'm going to make a video on doing those two, and then I'll make a little video about Rally 20s and take them both out for a ride. So there we are, that's things for the moment. Tomorrow I will take you outside and show you that trailer a bit more, and then I really must get on with things. Don't forget, I've still got some things for sale. The 21 inch Rally Courier frame hanging up there, that is still available. There's a Rally RSW Mark III, 90% complete, in nice condition. There is the little Dawes Nat. There is the purple Moulton with the blue Moulton for spares. There is something else which I forget, which slips my mind, all of which are around the 20-25 quid mark. So contact me if you're interested in anything. I dug out today at the lockup a couple of pairs of Moulton front forks as well, full-sized Moulton suspension front forks. I was thinking of maybe putting a pair in that purple Moulton that doesn't have suspension on it. So if you're not a regular, a lot of this will have gone over your head and think, what's he talking about? What's all these bikes he's talking about? Subscribe and you'll soon get back up to date, don't worry. Just on the topic of these lovely old red Bluemels mudguards, the mud flap. The mud flap was very cracked and split at the bottom, and it was scrunched up. It's something you often find when bikes have been stored with the front wheel out, or the mud flap's been caught around a tyre or something like that. You often find these old bikes when you rescue them that the mud flap is all scrunched up. So what I did was I cut off the bottom of it up to the top of the cracks and splits and just put a bit of a curve in it, and then the flap itself, 2 minutes on the radiator there, and it just goes very floppy. So all I did then was just hold it in my hand to the shape that I wanted it and dunk it in cold water for 5 seconds, and there you've got a nice reshaped, restored mud flap. I wish it was black, but we have what we have, you know. It's a nice period item. So the old trailer. Now part one is this doohickey attached to the back of the bike. And it's a simple triangulated affair. I think the whole thing is homemade. Look at the welding is not brilliant. The tubes are not pinched. There's no attempt at making anything aesthetically pleasing. But it's effective. A plate with a bolt which you can't really see. One of these trailer fittings, like on a car trailer or a little drop side of a tipper or something like that. I'll show you how that works in a minute. So, as you can see, I just zip tied it on yesterday down at the lockup. Quickly zip tied it together to be able to tow the trailer the 400 yards back. So we have a hole. Now, I would have thought that would be a bigger hole so it would go over the axle spindle. That's what I would like. That's what I might modify it to. Just stronger there. Here, you see, it would have to go onto the eyelet for mounting the carrier, or on an old-fashioned roadster the seat stays a bolt on at the bottom, there's a strong bolt there you could use. But really it's better off going onto the spindle. Let me take you around to the other side. And here it is on the left hand side. So I think I'll modify that by drilling it out. Two holes in this side for some reason. And then at the top it goes onto the seat stays. That's obviously meant to use a P-clip, and the P-clip it will use, but with the lock and the rack mounting in the way, I just used zip ties last night. I also had my big Clarès panniers on there. So the question now is which bike to put it on. For the moment I think this is the obvious candidate, being the winter beater. For the moment, once the winter's over, I'll decide what to put it on, what I want to tow the trailer with. And that really is decided by what I do with the trailer. So I'll go and fetch the trailer around and we shall discuss. So here it is. It's quite a long thing. I don't know if it was made this long or if it's been extended. At some point in its life, it's had this very workmanlike aluminium tray, and it is aluminium, riveted together. Quite nicely made that, and I think it's not original because of this cutaway here. The swan neck of the trailer here. Obviously it goes down to create the correct angle so the trailer tows level. I'll come to that in a minute. And I think maybe the deck has come to about here or here at the furthest forward, and basically they've tried to maximize the length of the trailer. And good on them. And underneath, so it simply sits on there and then that falls over and locks. I would put a tow strap around that as well. Now underneath we have the main spar, so it's a simple T. Again, quite homemade looking, I think. That's going to need some attention to make sure it's safe. It looks to be. And it seems also to have been made with standard bicycle hubs, rather than wheelchair hubs, which would normally be the thing. I have a better axle assembly that I could use. However, let's look at this trailer in context. I have two things I could do with it. The main plan for it in the long term, I'm trying to balance the trailer, there we are. The main plan for it in the long term was to make a nice vintage looking wooden box, fit 26 inch wheels, the roadster size, a pair of the classic rally mud guards, and make it a vintage bike trailer. And yeah, it's all a bit cramped in here. And I would then paint the frame and the apparatus, the towing apparatus, in the colour of the bike that I chose, probably Rally Green, to tow it with a Superb. Since looking at it, I've decided against that, probably against that. I could get away with the 26 inch wheels because it's slightly down at the back. The wheels were just lifted up a bit. A pair of the classic fluted mud guards with the little white reflectors, little white tails and reflectors, it would look cute. And appropriate tyres. These obviously are supposedly BMX wheels. I think they're more like child's bike wheels. I mentioned earlier on about living in this climate, so I don't think those wheels are going to be good for maybe more than another winter or so. The thing is, I'm grateful because all I did yesterday was put some more air in the tyres, because there was some. It had been stood for 9 years that I've had it, and there was still air in the tyres. Trailer tyres always seem to go down, no matter what you do to them. So it worked, it will work during this little car free period, and I have no complaints. After that I might do a bit of beefing up. I might put some proper wheels, BMX wheels, wheelchair hubs. It's only an evening by the fire to build a pair of wheels, that's no problem. And take it from there, make sure the frame is safe, and just keep it as it is, as a hack trailer for the moment. I have my one wheeled bob trailer, and I also have the back end of a tricycle, which I don't have here. It's coming back into the warm. I have the back end of a Mission tricycle with wheels, which I had planned to do, and I may use the back axle for a vintage style trailer. I have a big old fishing basket there, I thought of maybe putting that on. But you know, I don't do shows and things, what would I use it for, where would I keep it? I'm going to get this huge fishing box. I don't do fishing, never have, but I picked these up cheaply at the boot sale. I'm going to put that into this aluminium tray and see how it goes. See how it goes this afternoon with a couple of sacks of dog food in it, whether the wheels fall off or not. That'll be the test. So there is the trailer, and you'll hear more from me shortly. Since I posted a photo of the bike and trailer yesterday, a lot of people have been asking about the panniers on the bike, so I'm going to do a short video on my three pairs of, and the story of, Clarice Covers Dutch panniers. That's going to be the next video. Hopefully I'll do it this afternoon. So meanwhile, stay safe, keep riding if you can. And in the spirit of Hubnut, since I mentioned him earlier,